Hi guys, welcome to our GeoServer tutorial. Last time we looked at how to add the layers, and we were able to add, or rather, yeah, add layers and creation of stores. We were able to create raster stores and a vector directory of shapefile store. And we were able to publish and also confirm and check that we have published them. And now we are going to look at how we can preview or view these layers in the QGIS user interface. So I've already started my QGIS, and this is how it looks like. So basically we are going to look at how to load, how to visualize a vector layer. Yeah, from GeoServer on to QGIS, inside QGIS. We're also going to look at how to visualize the raster layers that have been published in GeoServer on the QGIS user interface. So basically, you need to have the URL, the URL to whichever GeoServer you are loading. And how I may recommend us to do this is to, you need to come to your GeoServer. It may be in your local machine like mine, or it may be in some other website. So let me log out. So if you open your GeoServer, even if it's on the internet, the, you know, the user interface will be looking like this. And you can check what you call the service capabilities. So this indicates which services are supported. And in this case, these are what we refer to as the Open Geospatial Consortium Services, OGC Web Services, or OWS. These are compilation of all of these, and I think some others that may not be here. So we want to visualize our vector layers, and in this case, since we just want to view, we are going to use what you call the Web Map Service, the WMS, and the formats that are being supported by this GeoServer, 2.19.1 is WMS version 1.1.1 and WMS version 1.3.0. So to have a deeper understanding on what WMS is, I may refer you to the OGC Web Services, Web Map Service. So I'll just search this. I wanted just to check on the official page for the WMS. So you can check this link, the ogc.org/standards/WMS, which explains on this service, but we will also look at it in the QGIS series. So you may keep posted on the QGIS tutorial series. So in this we'll just add. So normally what you'll do, you'll just copy this and this WMS layer. So this is how it looks like. Yeah, it has downloaded some XML sorts. So we just remove it. We can just copy the link, and then this link we are going to add, open our QGIS and add the WMS. We have this WMS or WMTS in the browser. If your browser, you cannot view your browser, you can just right click on the panels, right click anywhere on this toolbar, and then you ensure that you have selected the browser, QGIS browser. So you have browser 1 and browser 2. So in my case, I have this browser panel. It will be showing these layers that you can add. So we'll add WMS layer as a new connection, and then I'll just call it my connection Athena. And then I will just paste my WMS URL here. And then I can add a configuration or an authentication. In this case, I'll just use the basic authentication to my server. And there are other options here that you can select. You know, the name and the URL are important. Especially the URL is very important, because you cannot load it. If you cannot load it, you know, it will ask you where are we getting this layer. So this is just an HTTP implementation for that points to our server, and it has all other options that we are going to look at. We have checked them in the QGIS tutorial series. So for now, I'll just leave it as all these options as default, and I'll click OK. Then it will say that I've entered a password and it will be stored locally. So I'll just say OK, but just note that these, in a production environment, it's better to have an authentication kind of system whereby you authenticate to your server using some like tokens or some other authentication system. So this one, I'm just doing it because it is my local or my test environment. So I'll just click OK. And when I do that, there's an arrow that wasn't there before here in this place. So when I collapse it, we see that we have Athena. And then if I collapse Athena, you see that it indicates that this is a GeoServer web map service. Maybe that type of WMS, because you have so many others like ArcGIS and all that. But in this case, we're using GeoServer. So we have the GeoServer WMS. So when I collapse it, you'll note that it shows us all these datas that we have, where we had published. So for example, if I double click, or if I just drag and drop one of these layers, or maybe I can just double click, let's see what will happen. So it is fetching that particular layer. So I think depending on this depends on the speed or wherever your server is. Yeah, so it depends, because if your server is very far away, or if your server is what you call the latency. So if the latency is not good, then it will take some time to load. And also the layer, if the layer has so many features and all that, it may affect the speed of the loading, because it's loading through the web, through the HTTP. So this is one of our layers. We can just try and check the properties. And we have under information, we can see the layer, we can see the URL for this layer. We can also see the source. And one thing you will note, this is where I was telling you the password is not very good to putting the password in a string format. You see, it is showing me the username and the password to the local GeoServer. It is also showing the coordinate reference system, the extent, the units, which are in decimal degrees, the width and the height, they're not applicable. And then we have the server properties. So all these are the properties that are supported by the GeoServer WMS. You know, it can read the abstract, it has keywords, it supports all these image formats, PNG, XML, and all that. But these details, we'll look at them at a later, at another video, especially in the QGIS, handling of QGIS and WMS in QGIS. So we have all these layers, this is how they look like. You can note that I'm also loading, I've loaded all the layers, including the topographical maps that I had added. So this is what we have. We have our topographical maps, and then we have also our vector layer. But in this case, it's not a vector. We refer to it as a web map service, because it is being loaded as a web map service. It is an image of sorts that is being loaded. So one thing that we can also check, we can also try and see if we can be able to change some properties. As you note, there's one limitation about using these, and is that you cannot edit. Like now we can't, in my back of my mind, since I'm the one who loaded these layers, I know that this is the layer for Kenya, like the Kenya words, the administrative level 3. But I cannot be able to know what this is, because so even if I click, we have this is what I get the feature ID, but it is one. So let me just disable some of these layers and leave the county layer. So if I click on one of the polygons, it gives me the properties of the whole polygon anywhere where I click. So that, and also the maybe the layer styling. You can see that it has the gray, and these grays, gray has been in the boundaries of black have been set by GeoServer. So that is also maybe another thing that you can note. So let me zoom on to one of the topographical maps using the zoom tool. Yeah, so this is how this looks like, and I can also pan around and see. Yeah, I'm trying to see if we can identify any feature of continuity. Yeah, probably this. This is a boundary that extends, so there's some form of either uniformity or continuity of sorts. Yeah, so basically this is how you display the web map service, or you display a layer from there, GeoServer. So in this case, we can also load the OGC web services. So these ones, this handles everything from WFS, WCS, and WMS. So yeah, so this is how you visualize a layer from the GeoServer onto your QGIS. So feel free to like, share, and subscribe. And if you have any queries revolving around these, the GeoServer and QGIS rendering of data, feel free to comment or add your comment in the comment section. So, thank you for your time.